kind of people are you looking for when you look for National Youth Theatre members?
You don't know. You just don't know. I'm never looking for anything in particular. It's what you see. And we've probably got the most diverse and, I think, colourful cross-section of young people imaginable in any youth group. From, on one level, the odd public schoolboy, for instance, and on another level, the roughest kids out of the back streets of Bradford and Liverpool. It is a great admixture. Socially, it's a great admixture, and this is marvellous for them because they're meeting from these totally different areas, and they both learn enormously from it. In terms of acting, it's something quite different because you can't always tell whether somebody can act or not. Most of the kids who come to us probably can't act very well anyway, but there's something interesting about them, and that makes them worth having in the company. The thing about the scene is this instant reaction to authority, to your orders that you get. Once the head comes in, he says, jump, run, sit, stand, crawl. You do it instantly, with sheer panic, terror, fear, anything you can show. So far, you know, you've just been thinking your way through the scene. Now you've got to start living the scene. You are kids in that school, and you know bloody well that if the head comes down on you, its privilege is gone, it's maybe a few more months in, and you've had it. You're stuck there maybe for another 2 years of your life. Okay, so stand by for the head's entrance.
What he needs the £200,000 for is to run their new theatre in the Euston Road. Camden Council had already built it, along with a new library, and named it after one of their councillors. He lived just round the corner from here. His name was George Bernard Shaw. The theatre has never been a guaranteed financial proposition. Even the West End has its problems. And though the Shore is virtually rent-free, can Michael Croft manage?
Financially, no, well, we're in a curious position because we've got the National Youth Theatre itself fairly well established and fairly well supported with grants from official quarters. But now, having got our home, we now have to run that and run it round the year. Because, as you know, it's going to be the home for the National Youth Theatre in the holidays, and then the rest of the year we're going to have professional productions here appealing to young audiences. We've got to run good theatre here with the seat prices at a level that young people can afford, and that is the whole point. And if we can't do that, and if we can't get this place full of young people, then we failed. We might as well not be here. I personally am not at all interested in just putting on theatre for the sophisticated minority, the 10% that already go to the theatre and like it. I want this place to be full of youngsters who never go to the theatre. That means very special problems. First of all, communicating to them, finding the means to bring them into the theatre, which we will be doing very much through the schools in the first place, where we have very strong links. Through the youth services, where we have very strong links. And then in this very area itself of Camden, where we are working, and the back streets here are full of kids. I want to see them coming in here. Maybe when they first come, they might tend to wreck the place a bit, but we have to anticipate that. The main thing is to get them in. And this is a special job. Getting them in is the main problem as far as I'm concerned. What goes on stage, that, as a director, that is my problem, to make sure it's good enough to hold their attention when they come.
What is it that you're trying to do for them, Michael? Are you opening their eyes to literature, drama, the arts?
On the one hand, I like to feel that they're getting something that is of cultural value. That's a dirty word, but what other word is one use? Equally important is the social side of it, in that one is offering an experience of meeting people that one would normally never, they never have a chance to meet, of finding out how the other half lives, of learning to live together. Perhaps even more important, learning about themselves, because a few weeks of this kind of work in the summer, which is very concentrated, maybe 12 hours a day, of living at very close quarters with people, they learn so much about themselves that they never knew. In that sense, it's a kind of a mixed university, but at a rather earlier age than the university usually is. And that side of it, without that, I wouldn't be doing it.